Hi, I'm Ed Felten. I'm a professor of computer science and public affairs here at Princeton and the director of the Center for Information Technology Policy. Welcome to the Conversation With series. Many of you would like to know whether you can study more than one thing, more than one topic at Princeton. And my experience, this is something that is easy for students to do. Many students come with an interest in something else besides the one topic that they want to major in. And one of the ways that we recognize that in students' diplomas is through certificate programs, which are sort of the equivalent of minoring in a particular topic. Princeton really encourages people to follow their intellectual interests. I came here 17 years ago as a pure technology professor, but I got interested over time in public policy and how technology interacted with the decisions that government and society makes. And people across the university were excited to see a faculty member taking off in a new direction and combining different areas of study, just as we encourage students to do the same thing. A big part of what Princeton is about is drawing those connections across traditional disciplines. Students are often interested in whether they can focus on computer science or information technology and issues of public policy or sociology or economics at the same time. And we have a growing number of students who do that. That's one of the reasons we set up the program in information technology and society. An example would be a student who wants to understand how technology can enable economic development and a better life for people in the developing world in Africa or elsewhere. So that student has the opportunity to take technology classes, they have the opportunity to take classes in economics and sociology and public policy, all around these issues, and then to do independent work and a senior thesis that really draws it all together. I think the intersection between computer science and society is a fascinating area to work in, and it touches all kinds of important things that go on in our lives. We study electronic voting and elections. We study intellectual property, which accounts for a bigger and bigger fraction of the economy and a lot of the devices and products that we deal with every day. We deal with things like the safety of cars and the stability of technologies that underlie the banking system. We deal with issues of national security and the balance of power around the world. We deal with economic development in the developing world. All of this is connected to information technology these days. One of the early studies we did on electronic voting was to really take apart an electronic voting machine that was, at the time, used by about 10% of US voters. And we found that it was, in fact, possible to steal an election in a way that wouldn't be discovered. And we demonstrated it in many places. I demonstrated it for Congress, we demonstrated it on CNN and Fox News. And this has led to some changes in the way elections are held in a bunch of states, including California, Ohio, and Florida. One of the problems with electronic voting machines is the worry that someone is going to program them to do something other than count the votes correctly. This is a Sequoia AVC Edge voting machine, which would normally be used in election in the United States, but some of our students built a version of Pac-Man to run on this voting machine. I've been teaching about computer technology and public policy here at Princeton for quite a while, but now I have the opportunity to put this into practice. I've been appointed as the chief technologist at the Federal Trade Commission in Washington, and so I'm going to go off and do that for a while. When I come back afterward, I'll be able to teach this material in, I think, a different way. I can see that already. And with real-world examples and a kind of insight that you only get from doing something. Thanks for joining me on this installment of Conversation With. I hope you'll join me next time when I answer questions submitted on Facebook.